Father, we come to you this morning. And Lord, both as individuals, families, and collective. Lord, it just amazes me the barrage of frustrations, disappointments, questions, heartaches, and pains that we looked at before your throne this week, and in particular even this week. Lord, we come collectively. And even though we celebrate your goodness and your grace and your love and your mercy, Lord, we come collectively and we declare as a church body that we need you. Lord, we desperately need you this hour. Lord, we need our tanks refueled. We need the spring in our step reignited. We need the smile on our face put back on. Not because circumstances may change or situations may alter, but because we realize maybe for the first time or just in a fresh moment, what your grace and your mercy and your love really is. And so, Lord, we declare the words of that song that we need thee. We need thee this hour. Lord, may that be our focus today. It is in the name of Jesus Christ we pray. Amen. Thank you. You may be seated for a few moments. I do want to welcome those of you who are first-time guests here at First Baptist Church of Conyers, Georgia. We want to welcome you and let you know that we believe wholeheartedly in not sending any junk mail or any spam email to anybody. We believe in what we call the golden rule: do unto others as you would have them do unto you. But that being said, there is a visitor's card in the pew rack in front of you. If you're a guest with us today, would you do us an honor and a favor of letting us know how you came at the First Baptist? You may be here with family, you may be here with friends, or maybe you're one of those that we have the privilege of meeting every week, that you are new to our community for whatever amount of time, and you're stopping by, maybe you don't know anybody else except that you've seen the sign out on the road. We just want to welcome you and know how you came to First Baptist. And in a moment, when we collect our offerings for our tithes and offerings, would you do us a favor, and that be your gift to us? Would you let us know how you came to First Baptist? In fact, at the end of our service, if you're a first-time guest or visitor, we will have a reception in between our two services, and we'd love to meet you face-to-face in addition to that small piece of paper. I mentioned in my prayer that it's been a tough week for a lot of folks for a lot of different reasons, and maybe you're not one of those that's had a rough week. Maybe this has been the best week of your life, irregardless of circumstances, irregardless of scenarios in our life. We have come today to celebrate and to proclaim from the Word of God what we call the Gospel of Jesus Christ. Now, we know about the Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, but the word literally means good news. What that means is in the midst of life circumstances, Jesus is good news. In the midst of disappointments, Jesus is good news. In the midst of all kinds of frustrations and questions, Jesus still remains the Gospel for our life. And so it is with pleasure that I introduce our celebration choir and orchestra, who's going to remind us again the impact and importance of the Gospel.